Hi there, folks, and welcome to Quarantine Trivia number 3. My name's Sean. I'll be your quiz host again today. Thank you for anyone who's come back from our previous quizzes, and a big hello to anyone who's joining us for the first time. So we've been doing this for a couple of weeks now. Hopefully we're getting the hang of it. Format is going to be the same as usual. It's 12 rounds, 6 questions apiece. Each round we'll go through the questions and then we'll go through the answers straight after that, so we can keep a tally on who's doing what. This time we're adding something a little bit new, putting a link up for a Google Forms so that you can submit your answers to me and we can keep a tally and we can maybe set up a scoreboard. If you don't want to do it, you don't have to, but I thought it might be a bit of fun to try. So we will move on. So quick note just before we go on to the actual quiz. So as I said on previous weeks, it's a free quiz, but if you do find that you've got a couple of dollars or a couple of pounds to spare from whatever reason, you're not traveling or not going out socializing or for whatever reason, would just ask that you please consider a small donation to a charity. I try and raise money for the Al Kow Foundation here in Phnom Penh. We raise money for it's the only free primary school here. Donations can be made at the link above, kidsneededucation.org. You can also see a bit of information about the school and about the foundation. I think it's a very worthwhile cause personally, but if you want to give a donation to any other charity, that is also very welcome. Okay, so we'll move on straight away to round one, which will be general knowledge. Okay, so you can see up at the top right, there's a link to it. There's a Google URL. I'll put the link. The link should be in the chat as well. So if you want to open that up in a new tab, and keep me in this tab so that you can do both. Otherwise, just play along on a pen, a pencil, or in your head if you're just playing by yourself and just want to test yourself. So, moving on, round one, question number one. By what name is Barbara Millicent Roberts better known? And if you're not sure who she is, I can confirm you, there's almost no chance that you will not have heard of her. So, what is Barbara Millicent Roberts better known as? Okay, moving on to question number two. Who committed the first murder in the Bible? Nice happy question there for you. So, who committed the first murder in the Bible? Okay, that's enough time there. Question number three. Which drink is often referred to as the Green Fairy? Okay, so which drink is often referred to as the Green Fairy? Think it's come up in a number of different sort of places. The one that springs to mind for me was in Moulin Rouge. The Green Fairy was played by Kylie Minogue. Okay, question number four. Which two-letter word can come before at and red and after bin and man to produce four different words? So this is one two-letter word that can be used before any of these. So before, at, and red, and after, bin, and man, and it produces four new words. I'll give you a couple of seconds on this one. It's a bit of a thinker. I'll have a little refreshment. Okay, if you need more time, I guess you can pause the video. But moving on, question number five. Which popular sport features in the NATO phonetic alphabet? So the NATO phonetic alphabet is a standard alphabet. You probably know most of it. It sure begins Alpha, Bravo, Charlie, Delta. So obviously, it's not any of those answers there, but one of the words that they use is a sport. Which one is it? Okay. And question number six, last one in the round. What song replaced Bohemian Rhapsody at number one in the UK charts, and the title of which is contained in the lyrics of Bohemian Rhapsody? Okay, so the name of the song that overtook Bohemian Rhapsody in the UK charts was actually in the lyrics of Bohemian Rhapsody. What was it? Okay, and we'll give you a minute or so on this one. Okay, I'll just quickly go back through the questions again. Question one, by what name is Barbara Millicent Roberts better known as? Question number two, who committed the first murder in the Bible? Question number three, which drink is often referred to as the Green Fairy? Question number four, which two-letter word can come before at and red and after bin and man to produce four new words? Question number five, which popular sport features in the NATO phonetic alphabet? And question number six, what song replaced Bohemian Rhapsody at number one in the UK charts, the title of which is contained in the lyrics of Bohemian Rhapsody? Okay, so if you want to get your answers in, get them sent off to me via the Google Forms if you're doing that. I will try and get those updated as and when. I'll do it in the chat section because these videos are pre-recorded. So I don't know at the time of recording what your answers are going to be. So anyway, talking of answers, we will get on with the answers to this round. So question number one, Barbara Millicent Roberts is better known as Barbie. Barbie, the doll, very famous doll there. Question two, who committed the first murder in the Bible? It was Cain. Okay, he killed his brother Abel. Okay, question number three, which drink is often referred to as the Green Fairy? That is absinthe. Absinthe, banned for a long time, I believe. I think the hallucinogenic ingredient was wormwood, if I'm right in thinking. If I'm not, let me know. Question number four, which two-letter word can come before at and red and after bin and man to produce four new words? The word we're looking for is go, G-O. So with that, you would get goat, gourd, bingo, and mango. Okay, question number five. Which popular sport features in the NATO phonetic alphabet? That is, of course, golf. Golf, G for golf. And question number six, which song replaced Bohemian Rhapsody at number one in the UK charts, the title of which was contained in the lyrics of Bohemian Rhapsody? It was Mamma Mia by ABBA. So in the lyrics is Mamma Mia, Mamma Mia, Mamma Mia, let me go. I'm not going to sing it. And you should probably be thankful for that. Okay, so I hope you did okay on that. We'll move on to round number two. Round number two is called The Fear. So these could be anything fear related. So question number one, Don't Fear the Reaper was a song by which rock group? Okay, Don't Fear the Reaper was a song by which rock group? Question number two, We've Nothing to Fear But Fear Itself is a quote by which President of the USA from his inaugural address in 1933? So maybe the year should give you a bit of a clue there as well. It wasn't Donald Trump. So We've Nothing to Fear But Fear Itself is a quote by which President of the USA from his inaugural address in 1933? Okay, question number three. Which psychological thriller film of 1962, starring Robert Mitchum, was remade in 1992, this time starring Robert De Niro? Okay. So, which psychological thriller film of 1962, starring Robert Mitchum, was remade in 1992, this time starring Robert De Niro? Question number four. What was the fourth novel featuring Sherlock Holmes to be published by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle? Okay, so to say the round is called The Fear, so that should give you a bit of a clue. So, question four again. What was the fourth novel featuring Sherlock Holmes to be published by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle? Question number five. What is xanthophobia a fear of? Is it A, trees, B, the colour yellow, or C, metal detectors? Okay, so again, what is xanthophobia a fear of? Your choices are trees, the colour yellow, or metal detectors. Okay, and question number six. Who directed the film Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas? Brilliant film. Okay, who directed the film Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas? Okay, just a quick recap of those. Question one, Don't Fear the Reaper was a song by which rock group? Question two, We've Nothing to Fear But Fear Itself is a quote by which US president? Question three, which psychological thriller film of 1962 starring Robert Mitchum was remade in 1992 starring Robert De Niro? Question four, what was the fourth novel featuring Sherlock Holmes? Question number five, what is xanthophobia a fear of? Is it trees, the colour yellow, or metal detectors? And finally, question number six, who directed the film Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas? Okay, so hope you've got through that round. Get your answers sent over again. Nothing to be scared of if you want to make a pun about it. So we'll move on to the answers again. So, question number one, Don't Fear the Reaper was a song by Blue Oyster Cult. Blue Oyster Cult. Okay, question number two, We've Nothing to Fear But Fear Itself was a quote from Franklin D. Roosevelt. So that's Franklin D. Roosevelt. Question three, the psychological thriller film starring Robert Mitchum and remade with Robert De Niro. It was Cape Fear. Cape Fear. Question number four, the fourth novel featuring Sherlock Holmes. It was The Valley of Fear. The Valley of Fear. Okay, what is that? Question number five, what is xanthophobia a fear of? It is a fear of the colour yellow. So you might have a slight issue watching this quiz if you have that phobia. And finally, question number six, the director of Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas is, of course, Terry Gilliam, one of the Monty Python crew. Okay, so moving on. Round number three is A Rose by Any Other Name. Okay, so these are all people, places, or things, I believe, who've changed their name. Okay, so question number one. What did the country Swaziland change its name to in 2018? Okay, so that Swaziland changed its name in 2018. What did it change it to? Question number two. In which year did the British monarchy change their name from Saxe-Coburg-Gotha to the less German-sounding Windsor? Okay, so there might be a slight clue there in the question. So, in which year did the British monarchy change their name from Saxe-Coburg-Gotha to the less German-sounding Windsor? Okay, question number three. By what name is actor Morris Micklewhite better known as? Okay, so by what name is actor Morris Micklewhite better known as? And you can guess why he's changed his name there. It's not exactly a Hollywood name, that is it, Morris Micklewhite. Okay, question number four. True or false? In the Star Wars movies, Luke Skywalker was originally going to be called Luke Starkiller. Okay, so in the Star Wars movies, Luke Skywalker was originally going to be called Luke Starkiller. True or false? Question number five. Which country was formerly known as Siam? Okay, so which country was formerly known as Siam? And question number six, another multiple choice one here. Which infamous horror movie was originally titled Head Cheese? Not such a scary name there. So was it The Texas Chainsaw Massacre? Was it Nightmare on Elm Street? Or was it Chucky? Okay, so which infamous horror film was originally titled Head Cheese? Was it The Texas Chainsaw Massacre? Was it Nightmare on Elm Street? Or was it Chucky? So again, quick recap. Question one, what did the country Swaziland change its name to in 2018? Question two, in which year did the British monarchy change their name from Saxe-Coburg-Gotha to the less German-sounding Windsor? And question number three, by what name is actor Morris Micklewhite better known as? Question number four, true or false? In the Star Wars movies, Luke Skywalker was originally going to be called Luke Starkiller. And question number five, which country was formerly known as Siam? And question number six, which infamous horror film was originally titled Head Cheese? Was it The Texas Chainsaw Massacre? Was it Nightmare on Elm Street? Or was it Chucky? Okay, so we'll move on to the answers for these. So, question number one. What did Swaziland change its name to in 2018? It changed its name to Eswatini. So that's quite a strange one, this, because it's a lowercase e and then a capital S. And it's all one word. So the capital letter isn't the first one. So it's Eswatini. Although we're not too worried about spelling here. If you got close to that, you get the point. Okay, question number two. In which year did the British monarchy change their name from Saxe-Coburg-Gotha to the less German-sounding Windsor? It was 1917. Okay, 1917. Okay, and question number three. By what name is actor Morris Micklewhite better known as? He's better known as Michael Caine, of The Italian Job and more recently the Batman films and Inception and many, many other things. But Michael Caine. Question number four, true or false? In the Star Wars movies, Luke Skywalker was originally going to be called Luke Starkiller. That is true. It's probably a good thing that they did change the name. Although they did mention this in one of the most recent Star Wars movies where they had Starkiller Base. I'll not mention any more in case anyone hasn't seen the film. Question number five. Which country was formerly known as Siam? That was Thailand. Thailand. Okay, and question number six. Which infamous horror film was originally titled Head Cheese? That was the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. I believe there's a quote in that where it mentions head cheese in the movie, so that's probably where that came from. Okay, so moving on to round number four. I love cork and roll. So this round is what we're going to give you is some anagrams of rock and roll bands, and we want you to rearrange them to give us the name of the bands. Okay, so I'll just show you the first one that you see. So move on to your, oh, load up your Google form again, and question number one is Zipped Ellen. So what is this an anagram for? Zipped Ellen. I'll give you a little bit of thinking time on these ones. I'll just pretend I'm listening to some Zipped Ellen in my head. Okay, question number two. If you need a bit more time, as I say, you can pause these videos, especially if you're watching at a later date. But question number two, Camel Tail. Camel Tail. What is the name of this band? Okay, question number three. Snog's Nurse. Snog's Nurse. So again, these are all sort of rock and roll or metal bands. Okay, question number four. Ref Dappled. Ref Dappled. Okay, question number five. Forfeit's Hog. Forfeit's Hog. Okay, and question number six. Crippled their hopes. Crippled their hopes. Okay. And we'll go back over those again just quickly. Number one was Zipped Ellen. Number two was Camel Tail. Number three was Snog's Nurse. Number four was Ref Dappled. Number five was Forfeit's Hog. Okay, and number six was Crippled Their Hopes. Okay, so I hope you've got all those. Get them sent over to me. Now go over the answers. So, number one, Zipped Ellen. Hopefully, this was an easy one. Hope you all got it. This was Led Zeppelin. Led Zeppelin. Number two, Camel Tail. This was Metallica. Metallica. Number three, Snog's Nurse was Guns N' Roses. Guns N' Roses. Ref Dappled is Def Leppard. Def Leppard. Number five, Forfeit's Hog is the Foo is sorry, just Foo Fighters. Foo Fighters. And Crippled Their Hopes. It's the Red Hot Chili Peppers. So Red Hot Chili Peppers. Okay. So, moving on to round number five. Now, this is going to be a picture round. Called it the Man in the Surgical Mask. So, obviously, with the coronavirus and whatnot, there's a lot of people going around with the masks on. So, all I want you to do in these is to identify the people behind the mask. Okay, so number one, who's this? Okay. And number two, who is this? Amazing what you can do with 10 minutes Photoshop and an idea. Question number three, who is this? Okay, and number four, Who's this? Number five, who's this? And question number six, last one is who's this? Okay, so we'll go over those again quickly. Just give you another few seconds to have a look at them, see if you can figure out who they are. So, who's this? It's not in the outfit you'd normally expect to see him in. Number two is this. Number three. Number four. Number five and number six. Okay, hopefully you've got all those, got the answers sent over to me. So the answers for the picture round. Number one, as I say, not in the outfit you'd normally expect to see him in, but that was Lionel Messi, the Argentinian and Barcelona football player, the striker, I think he plays. Okay, number two was Beyonce, singer. Number three was Bill Gates. Number four was Jackie Chan. Number five was Scarlett Johansson. And number six, who probably should have been wearing a mask recently, was Boris Johnson. He's just out of intensive care, I believe, with the coronavirus. So, moving on, round number six. So, with this one, as the World Cup has been cancelled for this year, we're having a World Cup replacement service. As I've noted there, all the questions are actually about the Men's World Cup because I don't know enough about the Women's World Cup in football in that sense. So, question number one. All World Cup tournaments have been won by South American or European countries. Simply, which continent has more wins? Okay, so all the World Cups have been won by countries either from South America or from Europe. Which of the continents has more wins? Question number two. True or false? Only one World Cup has been won by a team with a manager who was not native of the country. Okay, so again, true or false? Only one World Cup has been won by a team with a manager who was not native of the country. So, as an example, if an English team was being managed by a Spaniard and they went on to win, they would have won with someone who was a manager but that was not native of the country. Hopefully that makes it clear. Question number three. Which country has qualified for every World Cup tournament? Okay, question number four. Which country has qualified the most times for the World Cup without ever getting past the first round of the competition? Okay. So again, which country has qualified most times for the World Cup without ever getting past the first round? So, question number five. Who, in the course of just 10 days, became the youngest player ever to score in a World Cup game, the youngest to score a World Cup hat trick, and the youngest player to score in a World Cup final? So again, in this course of 10 days, this player became the youngest player ever to score in a World Cup game, the youngest to score a World Cup hat trick, and the youngest player to score in a World Cup final. Okay, and question number six, last one in the round. In 1966, the World Cup trophy was stolen before the tournament started. What was the name of the dog that found it? So again, in 1966, in England, the World Cup trophy was stolen before the tournament started. What was the name of the dog that found it? Okay, so a quick recap of the questions. All World Cup tournaments have been won by either South American or European countries. Which continent has more wins? Question two, true or false? Only one World Cup has been won by a team with a manager who was not native of the country. Question three, which country has qualified for every World Cup tournament? I believe there's only one. Question number four, which country has qualified the most times for the World Cup without ever getting past the first round of the competition? Question number five, who in the course of 10 days became the youngest player ever to score in a World Cup game, the youngest to score a World Cup hat trick, and the youngest player to score in a World Cup final? And question number six, in 1966, the World Cup trophy was stolen before the tournament started. What was the name of the dog that found it? Okay, so get your answers sent over to me. And we'll go on to the answers. So, the World Cup replacement service. I hope you're not suffering from football withdrawal too much. Question number one. So, all tournaments have been won by South American or European countries. Which continent has more wins? The answer is Europe with 11 wins. South America has 9. True or false? Only one World Cup has been won by a team with a manager who was not native of the country. The answer is false. No team with a non-native manager has ever won the competition. Question number three. Which country has qualified for every World Cup tournament? That is, of course, Brazil. Question number four, which country has qualified the most times for the World Cup without ever getting past the first round of the competition? That is Scotland. Scotland. Okay, last time I believe they qualified was France 98. Haven't qualified since. They're not been doing so well as qualifying now. Question number five, who in the course of 10 days became the youngest player ever to score in a World Cup game, the youngest to score a World Cup hat trick, and the youngest to score in a World Cup final? That was, of course, Pele in 1958. He was aged just over 17 and a half at the time. And question number six, in 1966, the World Cup trophy was stolen. What was the name of the dog that found it? It was Pickles. Pickles. Okay. So, hope that'll tide you over till your next football fix. So, moving on to round number seven. This is called Based on a True Story. So, these are all movies that are based on true stories. I'm going to give you a few facts about them, and I just want you to name the movie. So, question number one, name the film. So, this was a film about the life of a rhythm and blues musician starring Kerry Washington and Jamie Foxx. It was released in 2004. So again, that's a film about the life of a rhythm and blues musician starring Kerry Washington and Jamie Foxx, released in 2004. Question number two. This was a film about smuggling unapproved pharmaceutical drugs into Texas for treating AIDS. This starred Jennifer Garner and Matthew McConaughey, and this was released in 2013. So again, this is a film about smuggling unapproved pharmaceutical drugs into Texas for treating AIDS, starring Jennifer Garner and Matthew McConaughey, and it was released in 2013. Question number three, the film about the life of Joseph Merrick, who suffered from a horrific disease. Starring Anthony Hopkins and John Hurt. This was released in 1980. So then Joseph Merrick suffered from a horrific disease with Anthony Hopkins and John Hurt, released in 1980. Question number four. This was a film about two athletes in the 1924 Olympics. This was starring Ben Cross and Ian Charlson. This was released in 1981. So again, two athletes at the 1924 Olympics, starring Ben Cross and Ian Charlson, released in 1981. Question number five, a film about the early life and career of Johnny Cash, starring Reese Witherspoon and Joaquin Phoenix, was released in 2005. So again, a film about the early life and career of Johnny Cash, starring Reese Witherspoon and Joaquin Phoenix, released in 2005. And last one in the round, a film about a former prostitute who was executed in Florida in 2002 for killing six men, starring Charlize Theron and Christina Ricci. It was released in 2003. Nice happy movie, family friendly. So again, a film about a former prostitute who was executed in Florida for in 2002 for killing six men, starring Charlize Theron and Christina Ricci. Released in 2003. Again, in case you haven't heard me say these enough. So, question one, a film about the life of a rhythm and blues musician starring Kerry Washington and Jamie Foxx, released in 2004. Question two, a film about smuggling unapproved pharmaceutical drugs into Texas for treating AIDS starring Jennifer Garner and Matthew McConaughey, was released in 2013. Question three, a film about the life of Joseph Merrick, who suffered from a horrific disease, starring Anthony Hopkins and John Hurt, was released in 1980. Question four, a film about two athletes in the 1924 Olympics, starring Ben Cross and Ian Charlson, released in 1981. Number five, a film about the early life and career of Johnny Cash, starring Reese Witherspoon and Joaquin Phoenix, released in 2005. And number six, a film about a former prostitute who was executed in Florida in 2002 for killing six men, starring Charlize Theron and Christina Ricci, was released in 2003. Okay, I'll take a breath and a sip of my beer. Okay, so get the answers sent over to me, and now we'll go over the answers. Just realize I'm touching my face there like you're not meant to do. So don't do that. Okay, so the film about the rhythm and blues musician in question one, it was Ray. The film was Ray. It was about Ray Charles. Question two, about smuggling unapproved pharmaceutical drugs, was the Dallas Buyers Club. The Dallas Buyers Club. Question number three, the movie about Joseph Merrick, was The Elephant Man. The Elephant Man. Question number four, about the athletes in the 1924 Olympics, was Chariots of Fire. Chariots of Fire. Question number five, the film about Johnny Cash was Walk the Line. Walk the Line. And question number six, the film about the former prostitute who was executed for killing six men was Monster. Monster. Okay. So, moving on. Next is another picture round. Who are you wearing? So, what we want here is we're going to show you some fashion label badges or logos, if you want, it's probably the better word. And all I want you to do is to name the fashion company or the label. Okay, so number one, hopefully a nice easy one. Who is this? Okay, number two, who's this? Okay, if anyone wonders what this sound is, it's just me opening another beer. Okay, number three, is this? Who's this? Okay, question number four. Whose label is this? Question number five. Okay, and number six. So obviously, some of these have had names on them at earlier points, and the names have been removed via the magic of Photoshop. So again, quickly, number one, number two, number three, number four, number five, and number six. Again, get your answers sent over to me, and then we'll go over these answers. So, number one was for Nike. Hope everyone got that. I believe it's known as the Nike swoosh, that logo. The next one, number two, was Gucci. So we're moving a little bit more into high fashion there. Gucci. Number three was Converse. Converse. I don't know if they do clothes as well, but I know they definitely do shoes anyway. Number four was Ralph Lauren. Ralph Lauren. Okay, number five was Abercrombie and Fitch. And number six was Levi's. Levi's, the jeans makers. Okay. A nice quick round there. So, moving on to round number nine. This is initial impressions. So, essentially, in this round, we're going to give you a bunch of names, and I'm looking for what the middle names are, what their middle initials are. Okay, so number one, what is Homer J. Simpson's middle name? So, what is Homer J. Simpson's middle name? Question number two. What is Michael J. Fox's middle name? So, what is Michael J. Fox's middle name? Question number three. What are J.R.R. Tolkien's middle names? So, we're just looking for the two R's there. What are J.R.R. Tolkien's middle names? 2 points available for this one. If you're keeping score at home. Question number four, another two pointer. What are George R.R. Martin's middle names? So George R.R. Martin is the author of the Game of Thrones books, or the Song of Ice and Fire series. It was made into the Game of Thrones TV series. Okay, so that's again George R.R. Martin, 2 points there. Question number five. What is J.K. Rowling's middle name? J.K. Rowling's middle name. Now, I believe that she actually doesn't have a middle name as such, but she gave herself a middle name basically so she could have a middle initial as her nom de plume. So, what is J.K. Rowling's middle name? And finally, what is Paul McCartney's middle name? What is Paul McCartney's middle name? Okay, so go over those quickly. Number one is what is Homer J. Simpson's middle name? Number two is what is Michael J. Fox's middle name? Number three, what are J.R.R. Tolkien's middle names? Number four is what are George R.R. Martin's middle names? Question number five is what is J.K. Rowling's middle name? And question number six, what is Paul McCartney's middle name? Okay, so get those sent over to me and I shall go over the answers now for you. So, Homer J. Simpson's middle name. They made a whole episode out of this one, I believe, where they were trying to. He went on a quest to find his middle name, and it turned out his middle name was J. J-A-Y. Middle name J. So, question number two. What is Michael J. Fox's middle name? This one might be a bit of a trick one, I think, but Michael J. Fox's middle name is actually Andrew. He just, like with J.K. Rowling, he uses the J for his acting, so he just performs under the name Michael J. Fox. Question number three, what are J.R.R. Tolkien's middle names? They are Ronald and Ruel. So Ronald and Ruel. Ruel, spelled Reuel. So I assume my pronunciation is right. If it's not, there's not much I can do about it now. Question number four. What are George R.R. Martin's middle names? They are Raymond Richard. So Raymond Richard. Well done if you got those. J.K. Rowling's middle name is Kathleen. Kathleen. And number six, what is Paul McCartney's middle name? This one again was a little bit of a trick one. Paul McCartney's middle name is Paul. He's actually called James Paul McCartney. Okay. So hopefully you're not too mad at me for those questions. So moving on to round number 10. This round is called Vowels. Where we're going, we don't need vowels. So I'm going to give you some clues to words, and you might have guessed it here. All the words, none of them have vowels. So there's only going to be so many different words it can be, so hopefully you should be able to get them all. So question number one. This is sung in a church. This is sung in a church. Nice easy one to start with there, I think. Question number two. This is an abnormal membranous sac in the body. So this is an abnormal membranous sac in the body. Question number three. This is an underground vault or chamber, especially used as a burial place. Okay, so again, this is an underground vault or chamber, especially used as a burial place. Question number four. Question number four there. This is the immature form of an insect, such as a grasshopper. Okay, so this is the immature form of an insect, such as a grasshopper. Question number five. This is a private romantic rendezvous between lovers. Again, a private romantic rendezvous between lovers. Probably not so many of these happening at the moment with the social distancing. And question number six. This is a valuable aromatic gum resin obtained from several trees and shrubs in Africa and Arabia, used in perfume. Okay, so again, this is a valuable aromatic gum resin obtained from several trees and shrubs in Africa and Arabia, used in perfume. So again, quick recap. Question one, this is sung in a church. Question two, this is an abnormal membranous sac in the body. Question three, this is an underground vault or chamber, especially used as a burial place. Question number four, this is the immature form of an insect such as a grasshopper. Question number five, this is a private romantic rendezvous between lovers. And question number six, this is a valuable aromatic gum resin obtained from several trees and shrubs in Africa and Arabia and used in perfume. Okay, so hopefully you got all those sent over to me. So, answers. Number one, sung in a church. That's of course a hymn. Hymn, Hymn. Hymn. This is where answers on the screen might be useful. Question two, an abnormal membranous sac in the body. This is a cyst. A cyst, CYST. Number three, an underground vault or chamber, especially used as a burial place, is a crypt. A crypt, CRYPT. Question number four, the immature form of an insect, such as a grasshopper, that is a nymph. A nymph, NYMPH. Question number five, a private romantic rendezvous between lovers. This is a tryst. A tryst, TRYST. And finally, the valuable aromatic gum resin obtained from several trees and shrubs in Africa and Arabia, used in perfume. Also very well known from the story of Jesus's birth. It is myrrh. 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 There's not many times you get to mention myrrh. That's one of them. Okay, so moving on to round number 11. So we're nearly there, nearly finished. Last two rounds are always music, so music trivia and then music intros. So again, get your Google Forms loaded up, ready to go. So, question number one. Which British 1980s pop group took their name from a mad scientist in the movie Barbarella? Again, which British 1980s pop group took their name from a mad scientist in the movie Barbarella? Question number two. In 1985, who was Saving All My Love for You? So, who was Saving All My Love for You? Question number three. The longest running number one album by a female solo artist in the history of the UK and US album charts is by which English singer-songwriter? Okay, so I'll give you that one again. The longest running number one album by a female solo artist in the history of the UK and US album charts is by which English singer-songwriter? Question number four. Which beverage links the songs Livin' La Vida Loca by Ricky Martin, Killer Queen by Queen, and Hotel California by the Eagles? So this is a beverage that is linked, that is mentioned in the lyrics to all of the songs. So again, that's Livin' La Vida Loca, Killer Queen, and Hotel California. Okay, give you a second on that one. I'll give you a clue, it's not beer. Okay, question number five. Who played drums on Back in the USSR on the album The Beatles, also known as The White Album? Okay, so again, who played drums on Back in the USSR on the album The Beatles, also known as The White Album? And lastly, question number six. Which group had a 1980s hit with the song Ghost Town? Okay, so which group had a 1980s hit with the song Ghost Town? So, a quick recap. Question one, which British 1980s pop group took their name from a mad scientist in the movie Barbarella? Question two, in 1985, who was Saving All My Love for You? Question three, the longest running number one album by a female solo artist in the history of the UK and US album charts is by which English singer-songwriter? Question number four, which beverage links the songs Livin' La Vida Loca by Ricky Martin, Killer Queen by Queen, and Hotel California by the Eagles? Question number four, sorry, question number five, who played drums on Back in the USSR on the album The Beatles, also known as The White Album? And question number six, which group had a 1980s hit with the song Ghost Town? Okay, so again, get your answers sent over to me on the Google Forms. And we'll go over the answers. Just pull up the answers here. So, yep, question number one. The 1980s British pop group was Duran Duran. Question number two. In 1985, who was Saving All My Love for You? It was, of course, Whitney Houston. Question number three. The longest running number one album by a female solo artist in the UK and US album charts is by Adele. Adele for her album 21. Question number four, what beverage links the songs Livin' La Vida Loca, Killer Queen, and Hotel California? The answer is champagne. Champagne. So in the lyrics, so Livin' La Vida Loca uses, she never drinks the water and makes you order French champagne. Killer Queen as Moe a Chandon in her pretty cabinet, and Hotel California is Pink Champagne on Ice. Question number five: who played drums on Back in the USSR on the White Album? It was Paul McCartney. So Ringo had briefly left the group during the recording of the White Album, leaving Paul to handle the drums. And the group with the 1980s hit song "The Ghost Town," "Ghost Town" is The Specials. The Specials. Okay, so moving on to our last round. This is our music intro. So for this, you'll hear it'll be about 20, 25 seconds of a song. What we want is the name of the artist and the name of the song. Each are worth a half point each. You'll hear six songs, and then we'll go on to the answers. It's about 5 to 7 seconds gap between each one. Only other thing I would say is these songs have been very slightly slowed down to try and get around a copyright notices from Facebook, because first time I tried doing this, I kept getting notices with every song and they wouldn't let me play the videos later. So hopefully that won't be an issue here. So we'll go on with the intros. There isn't a theme this week. Okay, so it's just six songs. So name of the artist and name of the song. And here we go.
I'm in love with you.
Time goes by so slowly. Time goes by so slowly.
Let's go, girls.
Okay, so that was the end of the intro. So now we'll move on to the answers. Okay, so number one was Skater Boy by Avril Lavigne. Number two was Ordinary People by John Legend. Number three was Hung Up by Madonna. Number four was Survivor by Destiny's Child. Number five was Man, I Feel Like a Woman by Shania Twain. Number six was Black Hole Sun by Soundgarden. Okay, so I hope you got all those. So get your answers sent over to me. I will, once the quiz is ended, I'll do a tally and I'll get information put out on the group so we can see who's done best, unless obviously nobody's decided to use it, in which case I won't bother. But I hope you will have used it, and we'll go from there. So thank you for taking part in the quiz. I hope you enjoyed it. Feel free to send your suggestions for future rounds and any changes you might want to see. And remember to stay safe and keep washing your hands. Thank you and good night.